Friday the 4th, it's fourth day of athletics here at the Shuanglao Sports Centre Stadium in Chengdu. The World University Games is cracking along at quite a pace and we have reached the halfway stage of the athletics programme. Well, it was Alisson Dos Santos who commanded the spotlight 4 years ago in Napoli, and he has done ever since, becoming one of the fastest men ever. So then, do we have another star in the making coming out of this final? Alisson Dos Santos broke his own South American under 20 record with 48.57 when he won this title in Napoli 4 years ago. He's gone blisteringly quick since then to become one of the best ever in the world. Here they come now in the latest edition of the World University Games, and down the back straight it's the Turk Berke Akam, who's going well. Rising first though is the man from Chinese Taipei, Peng Mingyang, as they reach the halfway stage. On the outside, Xi is trying his best to run his own race, but he's going to be overtaken as they come into the home straight. It's Peng of Chinese Taipei. The man from the host of the 2017 Universiade is being put under pressure, though, from Akam. However, Peng hits the last hurdle, hits it well, stretches away, and will win the title. 48-61. Nezir of Turkey takes the silver, and Turkey might have taken the bronze as well. But it's Chinese Taipei who take the gold, and he gets just as big a cheer from the home crowd as they would have done if he'd come from the Chinese mainland. Terrific race. Good time. Peng, he went hard. He was leading by 200. You can see they just leans back a little bit as the fatigue starts to wear in. However, he's got back under control by the next hurdle. And it's Akam who you saw there looking a little bit more tired. This was the important one. He needed to take it well. He did. And there was no way back for the Turks. But look at the rush here by the Chinese on this near side. Brought by the fading Akam inside to take that bronze medal. There's here doing him a favour. Pulling him through behind Peng. Confirmation then of his title in 48.62, a tenth ahead of Ismail Nezir of Turkey, with Xi Zhiyu of China taking the bronze. So the first rendition of the FISU anthem, Gaudiamo's Igatur, sounds around the stadium tonight for Peng Ming Yang.
The list of competitors
for the next final, which is the women's 3,000 metre steeplechase. Not starting, unfortunately, is Tina Estelle, Xing King, Huela Huang. It's Zhu Shuanghuang of China. The Asian Championship silver medalist this year will be one of the favourites to win this. Off we go then. So then we have athletes in this race from Australia, in Georgia Winkat from the University of New South Wales, who went to the World Championships in Doha in 2019. Samay Errol, we already saw, the European junior champion at steeplechase back in 2015. Italy's Linda Palumbu, who goes to the Free University of Bozen in Bozzano. Pauline Mayer of Germany, you can see her there on the inside, just behind Zhu. She goes to the IUBH Internationale Hochschule. Turkey has another representative with Semra Karaslan. Five national titles for her, for the woman from the Karakali University. India, with Bhagyashree Navali, goes to the Sri Govind Guru University. She will do well to keep up with the rest. She's only gone 10.5 minutes. Australia's second representative is Cara Freyan Ryan. And she went to the World Championships last year in Eugene, the woman from the University of Queensland. Looks like Zhu herself has decided she's going to take this out hard from the beginning. Been to the World Championships and the Olympic Games in recent years. Also a silver medalist in the Asian Championships in 2019, upgrading to gold this time around. There's a new leader, one of the Turkish women who has come through. Turkey with a growing. There was Zhu there, She was leading and now she's disappeared all the way to the back. It's maybe she went off a bit too hard. It's not the fastest of pace though as they head over the water jump. When they come round to the line again, there'll be five laps to go. They're already beginning to spread out. This is going to be tough for the 3,000 metre girls. This kind of heat, this kind of humidity. We're sweating and we're just sitting down up here. So then, Semra Karaslan from the Kırıkkale University. Personal best of nearly 9.5 minutes. Getting faster this year. To the bell then. And the Turkish athlete is starting to look a bit tired, but she's got a 20-meter gap. The bell will certainly reinvigorate her. However, will it also reinvigorate the woman behind her from Australia, Phelan Ryan? She's feeling good and she's beginning to come back. It's a big gap at the moment, but she's looking much the fresher. Could there be a victory for Australia coming? It's a big gap. It reminds me of the 2011 World Championships when Mo Farah was overtaken in the last part, and here comes the Australian. This is on. Australia, hold on to your hats, because here comes your girl heading for the back straight, and it could be a silver as well. In front, Kara Phelan Ryan, timing it beautifully. Huge belief, and the Turkish athlete went too fast, too early. Last chance here for the Turk. She could get caught by the second Australian, but she's digging in. Ahead of her though, here comes the Australian. Kara Phelan Ryan is going to take the gold medal, there's no doubt about that. But will the Turkish athlete Karaslan hold on for the silver? It looks like she will. She took a good final hurdle, but it's gold for Australia. Kara Phelan Ryan from the University of Queensland. Karaslan of Turkey from the Kırıkkale University holds on, and I mean holds on for silver. And Georgia Wincup from the University of New South Wales with a striding run, but not quite enough for silver. But nevertheless, it's a bronze. It's gold and bronze for Australia. Australia here taking the title for the very first time. Of course, the women's steeplechase only came into existence on the international scene in 2005.
And the steeplechase final there, times Australian Phelan Ryan, 9:46.02.
So all that experience from the World Championships last year for the Australian paying off this year.
And we have the women's pole vault competitors going down to 10 competitors, concluding with the Indian jumper, Tamila Larasan. Lining up for her first attempt at 4.40 meters, the French pole vaulter. And Dordain of France goes clear. I think it's 4.40, it could be 4.30. I'm just double checking my notes here. Good clearance, good high point, just nearly brushes the bar as she comes down. Oh, it's a clearance of 4.30, my apologies. 4.30, first attempt for Dordain of France. And this is Chen of China. You can see 4.10 meters, first time clearance, pass at 4.20. Goes straight to 4.30 now for her first attempt. Chen from China, good speed on the runway. Early plant, legs up. Oh, a good clearance from Chen. And the crowd are going to really appreciate that. And sometimes that's the noise you hear in the field events around the stadium. You'll have a Chinese athlete go and do something pretty good. And Chen has gone over 4.30 on her first attempt in this pole vault for women. Just four women left at this height. Only one to go, and she's in the medal range. Four women left in the pole vault. Moser came in last of Switzerland. She cleared 4.35. Over she goes. Great height over the bar. She's a quality jumper in terms of personal best. in this competition with the best this season of 4 meters 61. That, look at that high point, way above the bar and right on top of the bar, so you can just push away from the end of that pole and get over. So second attempt clearance of 4:35. So Chen, can she get over 4:40? Third attempt, 4 meters 40 for the Chinese vaulter. Oh, she's well high over the hips, but comes back down. Not enough penetration into the plant. A good early plant, shoots up, but she's not got that horizontal pace just to take and push off. She pushes off late and down it comes. Three girls clear, do not clear 4 meters 40. They all finish in second place. They three of them will take silver medals. And Moser on her own in the gold medal position, going for a third attempt at 4 meters 62. She's fast on the runway, full of intent. Oh, and she's gone clear. Moser, the motivation to do that when you've already won gold. What a great attempt that is, going clear on her third attempt at 4 meters 62. That's the season's best for Moser. She pips a season best by 1 centimeter. She's the class act in this pole vault event. And there's confirmation of that women's pole vault final result. Angelika Moser takes gold with 4:62, season's best. And then three silver medals as described. Petit France, Dordain France, and Chen of China, all taking silver. No bronze awarded. And the list of hammer throwers from their qualification from yesterday. Nobody achieved the 71 meter automatic qualifying mark. This is Dawid Pilat of Poland. Now he's got a season's best of over 73 meters. Let's see what he can do with this throw. Good shout. We like the shout. Oh yes, over 70 meters. Pilat 69.49 on his second throw. And now we're just waiting for that distance. He quite likes it. You always know when the hammer throwers like it. They punch, they shout, they scream as if it's going to help. 72.27 in the fourth round. Now he goes up into the silver medal position. So Pilat having some good throws here. And this is the man that's leading so far after three rounds. Chang of China. He's been consistent. Sorry, Wang of China. My apologies. 73.43 in that third round. He's been in the lead since the first round. And he likes that. Over that 70-meter line. The crowd like it too. And have we seen the winning throw go out in the fourth round? When you get to the fourth round, the order is reversed. So he would have thrown last in the last eight competitors in this fourth round. So you can see 73.63. He holds his place at the top of the leaderboard, but they're lining up behind him. Andrade from Portugal. Starting just that little bit further round, brings his right foot into the back of the circle there, and then turns and takes him across slightly at that angle, and he likes it. Jumps up. If you see a hammer thrower jumping up and down on release, you know they think they've got hold of it. Now, Andrade had two no throws in 3 and 4. He went 71-78 in attempt 5. That pushed him up the leaderboard, but he was in sixth position. Look at this, is what you're doing to throws. You pull it out in the last round. Very few people get the chance to come back. 73.43 moves into the silver medal position. behind Wang of China. And here we go, Wang, China, 73-63. Andrade in that last round effort, 73-43. Nearly snapped in gold, but takes silver. And Pilat of Poland takes the bronze.
Now then, the final of the women's 100-meter hurdles. Two Chinese, the rest all from different nations. Wu with a personal best of 12.86, but Anna Toth, insider in lane three, has gone quicker. Yota Yuraji, also 12.84 this year, and a 12.82 personal best, the fastest woman in the field. This could be a cracking race. 12.61 by Vashti Thomas in Kazan in 2013 is the Universiad record. It surely is under threat here if they get a good start. The crowd building, they expect Wu to deliver. Wu down on her blocks. The woman from the Beijing Sport University, personal best in the semis. May need to go faster here to get the gold. An eerie silence over the stadium. That's rare this evening. Set. Away we go then, and Wu gets a blistering start and hits the first hurdle first. Insider though, Forster is going really well. Forster has the lead at the moment. The woman from Slovakia might take this. Wu against Forster, two laps to go. Here they are over the line, and Forster has done it! Crushing the home country's dreams with a lunge at the line. Anna Toth down, tripping over the last hurdle. Forster praying, but you've got it. You are the Universiad champion. Toth is helped back to her feet by the Czech athlete, Tereza Sinova. Forster confirmed, new personal best, 12.72. Wu Yanni does get that personal best we talked about, but it's silver, but she celebrates it anyway. The family overwhelmed. Well, the final we thought would come has. It's not a Universiad record, but it doesn't matter. These girls have never run faster in their life. Really pushed each other. I love races where nobody buckles. They just drive each other on. See there to start with as well, the Italian, also going well in lane six, in the bronze medal picture. But in the end, just didn't quite have that smoothness over the latter stages. Determination on the faces of the eventual medal winners, as Anna Toth finally succumbed there on hurdle 10. Victoria Forster then, gold medal, 12.72, 400 ahead of Yanni Wu, and Yoti Yuraji of India takes the bronze. Hold on to your heartstrings, here we go with the women's 200 meters final then. This title in the past won by such greats as Marita Koch and Gwen Torrance, Kim Govert. There'll be a new name tonight. Could it be the name of Banelli Shibangu? Could she break 23 seconds for the first time in her career? The final of the women's 200 meters. Here we go then, eight women all looking to fit into three podium places, and Shibangu's got a fairly slow start. Fastest of them is Magdalena Lindner, the bronze medalist from the 100 metres, has run a blinding bend. Shibangu's got the work to do, but Lindner's coming through here on the inside, the German Wieland. But it's going to be Horowska, double gold for Poland. The long jump winner takes the 200 metre title as well. A fabulous track and field double for Nicola Horowska. Poland must be hardly believing what's going on at this
Well, it was a great run, wasn't it? She was fantastic out of the blocks and got a great bend under her legs. And then she's so strong, she just carried on running and there was no way they were going to catch her. It is a great double, But it just questions, is she a heptathlete potentially? You know, long jump and 200. A 200 time like that, that's world class in a heptathlon. The long jump goal was world class for a heptathlete. Yeah, anything around 650. So I guess, yeah, shot put and javelin, she may not be able to throw the spear, perhaps. That's the challenge, but she can certainly run and jump.
As Horoska is confirmed as the University Games champion, 23 seconds dead, 23:20 PB for Marlena Granieska and Vanele Shubangu, getting the bronze medal for South Africa. Straight off the back of that, the men's 200 metres final. So then Federici on the inside, then Inagate, Bogohain, Volko, Kay, Matsoso, Nishi, and Jan. The final of the men's 200 metres. The record still held by the great Pietro Mennea. We will probably not get near his wonderful time from the 1970s, but we will see a great race. Here we go then, it's a terrific start from the man from Chinese Taipei, K, already on the back of Volko. When you consider he's a 60 metre man, that is no mean feat. Off the bend though comes the South African, Matsoso, being chased after by the Indian Bogoyan. Matsoso's going to get there though, the Japanese closing, Matsoso takes it ahead of Nishi, and India claim another medal with Armin Bogoyan. Nishi has pulled a muscle in his attempts to get that medal, which he gets in 20.46, Matsoso in 20.36. And India have another medal here at the World University Games with Armia Bogoyan. Well, it wasn't the fastest race, but it was a well-fought one. It was a great bend from the South African that really put him in the driver's seat. He was too far ahead, they couldn't come back at him. Jan lost his form on the last 50, but the one man who kept it going from start to finish was the South African Isidore Matsoso. Confirmation then into, well, with a slight wind behind them, Isidore Matsoso wins ahead of Nishi and Bogoyan.
So Matsoso, South Africa, takes gold. Getting a good start, running a great bend, and then never giving ground. Nishi tried to chase him down, but he didn't, and Bogoyan finished well to pick up the bronze medal.